Hello everybody, Silver Picker here, and welcome to the Silver Picker Squad. Now, today's video is one that I'm super excited for because it is essentially my personal guide to buying coins online and reselling them for a profit. That is phenomenal, especially for the times we're going through right now, where a lot of people, including myself, can't really get to garage sales and estate sales and flea markets and the like. So this kind of arbitrage opportunity is really, really prime for these times. Now, in addition to that, I'm also going to be unboxing this package, which contains coins that I bought specifically for the purposes of reselling because I found a really good deal. And I found that deal using six different guidelines that I'm going to share with you for identifying a good coin, buying it, and then being able to resell it for a good profit. So let's take a look at these guidelines, and then let's check out these awesome coins. Let's go. Now, before we get started, just like this corner of the coin business is perfect for these crazy times right now, so too is the sponsor of this week's video, which is Requirin. Requirin is a super cool art company that basically lets you commission a painting of anything and everything you could possibly want. It's great for pet portraits, family portraits, and basically anything. You could even get a cool painting of your favorite coin or banknote, maybe even put yourself on a coin or banknote. You just send them a photograph of what you want, and they match you with an amazing independent artist to bring your creation to life in the style that you want. Now, the reason why I said this is great for times like these is because, frankly, I'm not able to see a lot of my family right now, and it is really hard. Specifically, my grandmother. I lost my grandfather just over a year ago, and it kills me that I can't physically spend time with my grandmother now due to the risks. So, here's what I did. I asked Requirin to match me with an artist who could do a copy of a famous photograph of my grandparents when they were young. To show you the range of styles, they had two artists do it, and this is how they came out. This is the first one. I think the artist caught all of their facial features really perfectly. I love that it was done in charcoal, and I love that it was done on this brown paper. It is really unbelievable because it gives that feeling of that time period, that age, and it also really is true to the photograph while also still being extremely artistic. And I'm gonna get this framed on my own because it is absolutely spectacular. And this is the second version. This one's a little bit smaller and it's in a much more modernist style, but I actually think I like this one better because even though the other one is, I think, more true to life, it's much more accurate to the actual photograph, I think I like the idea of it having this portrait feel. I mean, this is also a much more cropped image, much more close up, but that's what I think is so cool about Requirin and about how they have this network of all these amazing independent artists. It's not gonna be a factory product. Every single thing is gonna be unique, and you're gonna really get a true piece of art. It's really amazing. It makes me miss my grandfather. It makes me cherish my grandmother, and this is just such a special, special piece. And without Requirin, I don't think I would ever have even thought to do anything like this. So highly, highly recommend it. Now, my grandmother actually watches all of my videos, so she is seeing these portraits for the first time along with all of you. So, hi, Bubby. I hope you enjoy these portraits, and one of them is for you, and I will bring it to you next time we are finally going to be able to physically see each other again. Now, if any of you watching decide that you want a painting commissioned by Requirin, I would be more than appreciative if you would consider using my link down below, requirin.com/silverpicker, because if you do, it'll throw me a couple of bucks, it's a concrete way of supporting my channel, and it won't cost you a dime extra. And frankly, it's also a concrete way of supporting small independent artists and a small new startup, which is not half bad during these crazy times where independents and small young companies can use all the help that they can get. And if you do decide to get something, I would love to see it, and I would love it if you'd share it with the community, post it to my Instagram or Facebook, and I will happily feature it on a future video. I would love to hear the story associated with it as well. I am so happy with how this came out, and I can't wait for my grandmother to see it as well. So, back to business. Now, a lot of you know from watching my videos that I'm not a huge fan of modern commemorative coins. You know, I find them interesting, I definitely like the art on them, but I'm not a big collector. My big collecting passions are with the older coins, especially 20th, 19th, and 18th century coins, like what is in my typeset and in some of my other albums that you've seen. But given all these restrictions related to Corona and whatnot, I decided to see what else is out there. And I think the best way of finding out what's new and what opportunities are out there is simply by signing up for the email lists for all of the different mints. So that's my first guideline. It's simple. Literally just go to the US Mint, the Royal Canadian Mint, the Royal Mint, etc., and just sign up for their newsletters. Now, they will send you an annoying barrage of emails every time a new product comes out, but it's totally worth it because you will find the ones that sort of pique your interest and catch your eye, and it'll give you the immediate ability to go on the website and purchase before it gets sold out. Now, I am personally signed up for newsletters from like 5 or 6 different mints, so I actually got the email for this Elton John coin that we're gonna be unboxing today the day that it came out. And I'm a huge Elton John fan already, so I definitely was interested in this, and I opened that email, I checked it out right away. And that is, by the way, the second guideline is look into the different topics and different subjects that sell well, right? So is it movies? Is it pop stars? Is it historical events? There's so many different things that coins can commemorate or celebrate, and it's up to you to figure out which ones do the best in the marketplace at a given time. And sometimes it's not even enough just to know that singers or musicians do well, but you've got to drill down even further into subcategories. Now that's a topic for a whole nother video, and maybe I'll make an entire video on that, but for now you guys can do your own research, check eBay sold listings, check out what's going on in the marketplace, and try and get a sense of what topics and what subjects do really well. And I certainly think that superstar rock stars from the 60s, 70s, and 80s do extremely well. So that was an easy find with the Elton John coin. So after opening this email and checking out the website, I was pretty close to ready to buy just because I liked it. I thought it was a stunning coin. I normally don't treat myself like that, but I just love the singer, love the design of the coin, and I was ready to buy. But there was one critical thing that I needed to check first, and that was the production numbers. The production numbers, meaning how many coins of this particular type are actually produced, is hugely important to the value. In this case, 7,500 pieces were produced, which is very low, all things considered, right? Especially when you think of the magnitude of the superstardom that is Elton John, how many people like Elton John, how beautiful the coin is aesthetically, how many collectors would want it, and the fact that silver and gold and precious metals right now are exploding in popularity just in the general investing world because of what's going on. So between all of those different things, to me it seems like there is a lot of demand for this type of coin, and 7,500 really is not that much. So once I saw that number, I decided it was time to buy. And by the way, if you don't see the production numbers listed on the official listing on the official website, it probably means that these coins are being produced to demand, meaning they're gonna keep producing them as people keep buying them, so there is very little chance that they're gonna go up in value because they are just going to produce these into oblivion. Now, by the time I was ready to actually purchase the coins, over 95% of the mintage had sold out. That's right, literally on day one, over 95% of the 7,500 coins produced were already sold out, so I knew I had to act fast. And by the way, that's guideline number 4. Look at day one sales, right? So if there is a limited production run and within the first day almost all the coins sell out, that's a really good indication that there's a lot of demand. Now, right before I decided to click the buy button, I also went over to eBay to check out if there were any sold listings for this coin already, because what some people do is before the coin is even shipped, they will pre-sell the coin on eBay and actually make sales. And believe it or not, there had already been sales for like 20% higher than the initial offering price. So that was another good sign, and that's guideline number 5. Definitely check eBay sold listings and eBay listings in general before buying the coin, because you'll see if there have been pre-sales. And if there are pre-sales already on eBay, you know that demand is high. So for guideline 4 and 5, I checked the box big time because the coin literally sold out on the first day, and it was being pre-sold on eBay with a profit, with a premium, on day one already. So that is absolutely phenomenal. I put those babies in my cart, and I was right about to click purchase when it brings me to guideline number 6. Before you buy coins directly from the mint, make sure to search the internet for promo codes. Believe it or not, they offer tons of promotional codes all the time for all sorts of different things, and I was actually able to get a nice discount. So if you see here, listed on the website, these coins go for £95 each, which of course is way higher than spot, but we're not talking spot here. So these Elton John coins are listed for £95 each, so if I were to buy two of them, right, it would be £190 total. Well, check out what I paid. See, I saved almost £20 just by taking 2 seconds to search for a promo code. So I threw two coins into my cart, added the promo code, and hit the buy button, and my order was placed. I also went over to Patreon and I let my patrons know about that, you know, just a little added perk to let them know what I was up to, and a couple of them bought them as well, and I believe they are extremely happy about that. So anyway, as usual, a huge thank you to my patrons. If you're interested in becoming a patron, links down below. And a few weeks later, the coins shipped and arrived at my door. Now, I am jonesing like crazy to actually see them and open them up and see them in all their glory. So enough with the jibber jabber, let's open them up and see them together. All right, straight from England, straight from the Royal Mint, let's open this baby up. All right. Oh yeah, here we go. Wow, look at that. Look at that. Oh my gosh, it's even got like this sparkly star ink over here. Spectacular packaging. Really nice packaging. This is definitely going to appeal to a lot of collectors. All right, this one is gonna be the one that I am going to resell. So let's open this one up and check it out. Okay. That's the box. All right, so it comes with a little bit of paperwork, it seems. Nice heavy stock paper. Elton John, you can pause this here if you want to read it. I'll go through each page and you can just pause it if you want. I guess it's the history of Elton John. That's pretty cool. I would have liked a little bit more about the actual coin itself, but I guess this is pretty cool in any case. Ah, here we go. So this is about the design and the designer. Very cool. It seems that every single coin designer has the name Morgan somewhere in their name. That's pretty wild. All right, we've got the Royal Mint. You can see here it's matte black on black. That's super nice. I love that. Nothing on the bottom. And here we go. Wow, that is absolutely as nice as it looked online, and frankly, even though this is a pretty good camera, this is not doing it justice. This is a gorgeous, gorgeous coin. Ah, it looks like up here we have the certificate of authenticity and the number. So this is number 3,856 out of 7,500, so right smack dab in the middle. Let's take a look at this before we get to the coin. All right, so we've got the specs over here. You can see it's 2 pounds, United Kingdom, it's pure silver, it's 1 ounce. Oh, that's pretty cool. It's got edge lettering of Elton John. That's really cool. Two different designers, one for the obverse and one for the reverse. It is a proof. Now, interesting here, it says maximum coin mintage of 10,000, but then it also has this separate thing that says limited edition presentation, 7,500. So that actually is a little bit misleading, I think. It says maximum coin mintage is the maximum number of coins that will be issued. Limited edition presentation is the maximum number of coins or sets of coins presented in this specific style that will be issued. So that is actually a little bit misleading, but I'm still not worried because these still sold out, and I guess they're just sort of giving themselves an opportunity to sell an additional 2,500 coins if it does well, which I guess they will do. Anyway, I think that that's a little bit lame, honestly, but, you know, live and learn. In any case, I still think this is a great purchase. Now let's take a little bit of a closer look at the coin itself. Now it lifts right out of the case super easily, and you know me, I don't love colorized coins, but I think this just looks stunning. Look at the design. The colors are not overused, but they pop and they make the coin look so spectacular. I mean, if you guys are young and you're watching and you don't know who Elton John is, please check out a YouTube video and just watch some of his music videos, listen to his songs. I mean, there are so many smash hits and you will not regret it. Look at that. And then, of course, we have the obverse, 2020, 2 pounds. It's Queen Elizabeth for you. I am super happy with this. This will definitely sit on the backdrop of my videos because I just love how this looks. Huge Elton John fan. I hope they do more awesome, iconic British singers, rock stars, musicians, and I hope that the other mints sort of follow suit and do different rock and roll stars from their different countries. I would love to pick up, you know, some of these other iconic bands and maybe even start a little collection like that. So those are some awesome coins. Let's summarize what we talked about in this video so you are more than prepared to make some money buying and reselling coins that you find on the internet. So again, the first step is get in the know. Get on those mailing lists so you know that day one, these coins are gonna come out, because anything that's worth buying will be sold out within the first day or two. The second thing you want to do is collect knowledge. Make sure you understand the trends in the industry. Make sure you understand what's selling well at a given time. Right now, coins from rock stars from the 1960s, 70s, and 80s are doing amazing, but maybe in a year from now, superhero coins or comic book coins or something like that will be doing well. So make sure you're doing your research and keeping up with it. Number three is possibly the most important one, which is make sure you pay attention to the production numbers. A coin that's produced into oblivion that has millions and millions of pieces is really just not going to be a good target for resale. Make sure you get those low production runs, and that will be the sweet spot. Then, of course, take a look at day one sales. If within the first few hours, the coin starts to look like it's gonna sell out, that's a really good indication. And then with the fifth guideline, you're also going to wanna take a look at whether people are buying and selling them on eBay before the coin even launches. Again, another really good indication of demand. And finally, with guideline number six, when you're ready to hit that purchase button, make sure you spend a couple of seconds scouring the internet for awesome promo codes. They're all over the place, they'll save you money, and they will bake an extra 10, 20, 30, or even more percent right into your profit the second you purchase it. So follow these guidelines and you will be able to make some money sitting at home just like I did. Now obviously I haven't actually sold this coin yet, but if you're interested in finding out what I do end up selling it for, follow me on Instagram and on TikTok. The links are down below because that's where I'll be sharing those little updates. So anyway, I really hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something. If you did, put it in the comments below. If you think I missed something, put it in the comments below. And anyway, I've got a lot more awesome coin collecting, precious metal stacking, and even personal finance related content coming straight to you in the next couple of weeks. Every single Thursday I post a video, so stay tuned, and until then, Silver Picker out.
A huge, huge thank you to all of my wonderful patrons. You guys are amazing. Thank you so, so much for your support. I have been absolutely loving talking to you guys in the Discord. Things have been so interesting these past couple weeks. If you're interested in becoming a patron, now's the time.